a blessed morning, dear brothers and sisters in Christ. Welcome to Carmelite Monastery. Today is the first Sunday of Advent. Advent, which means coming, is a time of preparation for the Lord's coming. The Gospel for this first Sunday of Advent invites us to be awake and prepared. May we have this disposition as we start a new stage of our Advent pilgrimage. Let us now rise and welcome our Lord Jesus Christ in the person of his minister, Reverend Father Roy Christian Gisulgan. Shall now have the blessing of the Advent wreath.
Our help is in the name of the Lord,
who made heaven and earth.
Lord God, your church joyfully awaits the coming of its Savior, who enlightens our hearts and dispels the darkness of ignorance and sin. Pour forth your blessings upon us as we light the candles of this wreath. May their light reflect the splendor of Christ, who is Lord forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. We shall now light the first Advent candle.
Father, as we begin our Advent pilgrimage, begin our Advent, we light a candle of hope. Grant us the courage to hope for your presence, hope for your peace, and hope for your promise.
Amen.
Amen. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear friends, today we begin the new liturgical year with the first Sunday of Advent, and we await the Lord's coming. And so part of that waiting is our preparation. Brethren, let us now prepare ourselves, acknowledge our sins to celebrate the sacred mysteries. We say, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned, my thoughts and my words, what I have done, what I have failed to do. Through my fault, through my most grievous fault, therefore I ask Blessed Mary of a Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us everlasting life.
Amen.
Christ have mercy.
Let us pray. Grant your faithful, we pray, Almighty God, the resolve to run forth to meet your Christ with righteous deeds at his coming, so that gathered at his right hand, they may be worthy to possess the heavenly kingdom. For Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. Isaiah prophesies about the messianic time when all peoples will come together in the Lord's name. At that time, wars will cease and there will be peace. The first reading.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. This is what Isaiah, son of Amos, saw concerning Judah and Jerusalem. In days to come, the mountain of the Lord's house shall be established as the highest mountain and raised above the hills. All nations shall stream toward it. Many people shall come and say, "Come, let us climb the Lord's mountain to the house of the God of Jacob, that he may instruct us in his ways, and we may walk in his paths." For from Zion shall go forth instruction, and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. He shall judge between the nations and impose terms on many peoples. They shall beat their swords into plowshares and their spears into pruning hooks. One nation shall not raise the sword against another, nor shall they train for war again. O house of Jacob, come, let us walk in the light of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
To give thanks to the name. Pray for the peace of Jerusalem. May those who love you
Now that they have professed faith in Christ, the believers are reminded by Paul that it is time to awake from slumber and live honorably as children of God. The second reading.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Sisters and brothers, you know the time. It is the hour now for you to awake from sleep. For our salvation is nearer now than when we first believed. The night is advanced and the day is at hand. Let us then throw off the works of darkness and put on the armor of light. Let us conduct ourselves properly as in the day, not in orgies or drunkenness, not in promiscuity and lust, not in rivalry and jealousy, but put on the Lord Jesus Christ and make no revision or provision for the desires of the flesh. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please all rise.
Show us, Lord, your love and grant us your salvation.
Proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "As it was in the days of Noah, so will it be at the coming of the Son of Man. In those days before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, up to the day that Noah entered the ark. They did not know until the flood came and carried them all away. So will it be also at the coming of the Son of Man. Two men will be out in the field. One will be taken and the one will be left. Two women will be grinding at the mill. One will be taken and one will be left. Therefore stay awake, for you do not know on which day our Lord will come. Be sure of this. If the master of the house had known the hour of night when the thief was coming, he will have stayed awake and not let his house be broken into. So too, you also must be prepared, for at an hour you did not expect, the Son of Man will come. Friends, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ. The externals in our church has changed, and first we have the lighting of the Advent wreath. We have lighted the first candle, and that is the candle of hope. Also the vestment and the color of the altar has changed. Our Mother, the Church, is actually helping us to enter into a disposition that is the disposition of Advent. It is a disposition of waiting. It is a disposition of being prepared. I like our opening prayer for today because it sets the tone for our reflection. We just prayed, grant your faithful, we pray, Almighty God, the resolve to run forth to meet your Christ with righteous deeds at his coming, so that gathered at his right hand, they may be worthy to possess the heavenly kingdom. We are to run forth to meet the Christ. But running forth also entails that we are to bring something with us, and we are to bring our righteous deeds. The waiting of Advent is not a passive waiting, but an active waiting. We are to be busy. There's that sense of running, sense of urgency, a sense of activity. We are not simply to stay there, not doing anything. We are to run forth to meet Christ and present to him our righteous deeds. So it is an active waiting. We are to engage, we are to indulge with something to present the Lord. My dear friend, St. Paul, in our second reading, rightly puts it that this Advent is precisely about that, a way of life. And St. Paul presents the idea that in this running to meet Christ, we are to run because there's a movement from our old ways to new ones. May paglain kay nagadalagan. Kung nagadalagan ka, huwag ka pabilin sa point A. Kundi nag-move ka from point A to point B. And for Paul, that sensing of a movement is better expressed by a change in our lives. Hambal niya, metaphorically, he gives us, the night is advanced and the day is at hand. Let us then throw off the works of darkness and put on the armor of light. Let us conduct ourselves properly as in the day, not in orgies and drunkenness, not in promiscuity and lust, not in rivalry and jealousy, but put on the Lord Jesus Christ and make no provision for the desires of the flesh. This running forth entails a movement, a change in the way we do things. We put off the old ways and embrace new ways in Christ. That is what our Advent preparation is all about, my dear friends. It is to be indulged in active waiting. And our Gospel for today points out the very attitude that accompanies our active waiting. It is an attitude of always being on guard, always being prepared. Ang problema natin, kaya kita mga tao, mahilig nga maglingaw-lingaw. Di ba? Kaya ang kalibutan, makalilingaw. Di ba? Tiyang habas ang Ginoo, hindi maglingaw-lingaw. Our days at times are simply filled with so many activities, and as we go about our days, we fall into routine. We get used to, hindi ba? And at times when things change, we get, in a sense, no, topsy-turvy or disoriented. And so we want things to be in their proper rhythm, in their proper order, routine. No? And we get comfortable in the process. And so that is why the church also introduces in her church calendar changes. Anami man sa mga changes. Para hindi ka malingaw, no? Pero may ka lang ordinary time, hindi ba lang? Anami man may advent, no? May change. Oh. So the church jolts us, no? As if reminding us of important things. And so the Lord also reminds people, as in the days of Noah, people were doing things as they would do it daily. They get married, they eat, they drink, they have a good time, but life is not simply about the good times. Life is also about what is important, what is necessary, what is of priority, what is of value, and not simply any value, but what is of ultimate value. And so Noah saw this. Noah saw this while the rest were not able to perceive it. He saw it because he was a man of God. He was a man of prayer. And so he entered the ark while the rest remained outside. Beautiful, no? Kanami blako nagapangamuyo ka. Kaya makasulod ka sa ark ka. Kung wala ka pang amuyo, wala communication sa Diyos, you will be simply one among the many. No? Our life, ako gani in my reflection, no? In this life, we can choose to be simply numbers or to live life with meaning and purpose. Di ba lang? Masing ka, okay, unemployed ko, so I belong to the unemployed. Okay, poor ko, so I belong to the poor, no? Or educated ko, so I belong to the educated. No, you're simply a number. But you are not simply a number. You are a Christian. You are baptized with a name. And your purpose is to make a difference in this life. To make this world a better place. So we cannot simply live as if we are simply a number, a figure of the population. So what will make a difference between you and the rest? Your relationship with God. And Noah entered the ark while the rest perished in the flood. I like the metaphor that is used, no? The flood, a cleansing of the old order, because after the old order is done, there will rise a new order. And that is what we hope in Advent. And that is what Advent symbolizes. We are to transition from the old to the new. And these days are days of preparation so that we make possible the transition. Because only in God comes an experience of newness. Kung magabot ang Ginoo sa ato kabuhi, may experience ang newness pagbago. A couple of days back, we heard the readings talking about the the trees, and the buds that we can see among the trees. And we say, it is summer, beautiful. But the coming of summer is as sure as the coming of man. I like the adjective that was used by Luke in the gospel for today. Humble niya. Be sure of this. If the master of the house had known the hour of night when the thief was coming, he should have stayed awake. So too, you also must be prepared, for at an hour you do not expect, the Son of Man will come. With sureness, the Son of Man will come. Beautiful, no? Hindi ka pa ganyan kasigurado kung may maabot si Santa Claus kung may Pasko, hindi mo lang. Hindi ka pa ganyan kasigurado kung makitaan mo yung maninoy, no, sa Pasko. Kaya nagapinanago. But with sureness, the Son of Man will come. And it is that sureness that we hope for newness. Because when the Son of Man comes, He will bring a new order. Di ko magabot si Jesus, tsato naging hambal ni St. Paul in his letter, the kingdom comes to us. A change of life. The reign of God is with us. My dear friends, this is the things that we are to work on this Christmas. And hopefully the externals that we see changes, no? That we see around us, and the things that we do to make those changes possible coincides with the very invitation of Advent. Di bala? Nag-grocery ko kay hindi lang para sa akon, kay mapakaon ko sa tupadbalay man. O, di bala? Atika nami, may angot siya. O, nang bakal na ko nga daan, pamaskwa kay barato pa. Agod mas madamo ang akon mabakal, kag mas madamo ang akon matagaan. Di ka nami nga perspective, di ba? Ma-decorate ko Christmas para ma-remind man ang mga tao nga Christmas na. Kag hindi Santa Claus ang focus, kundi ang ninyo sa bilen. Kaya hindi kompletong dekorasyon kung wala bilen. Maskin wala snow, basta may bilen na. Ika nami, kaya nag-aangot ang imo, no? Kaya may isang balay na puraw na snow, di ba? May snowman pa, pero wala bilin. Ang imo Christmas wrapper, snowman, pero wala si Jesus, o, di ba? Nang greetings mo, holiday, pero wala Christmas, wala Kristo, na. Hopefully, the externals will facilitate a disposition. And that disposition is good that we pass on to our children. As a matter of fact, this season is also, in a sense, no, for us to reevaluate the things that we have been doing year in and year out, and hopefully move towards that, a sense of newness. We are to run to meet our Savior, and that running entails preparation and a disposition. So my dear friends, we have started to facilitate that disposition in church. And hopefully, as fathers and mothers, you also facilitate that disposition in your own families and your own homes. Mga Hudiyo, yaka namin kung magtipon sila, no? Para sa ilang hanuka, di ba? May candle sila, may mga prayer sila, no? Nag-prepare gid sila ya. Di kita yung mga Kristiyano, have we also that kind of attitude to prepare also our families this time of Advent? Ang ibang excited na, pero may Advent pa. Hindi na yung maglumpat sa Christmas. Maagi pa ta sa Advent. A disposition so that we can truly enter into what the church invites us this season. My dear friends, Jesus will surely come, and that is the basis of our hope, and that is the basis of all of these preparations. Amen. Let us now rise and profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten and made consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, proceeds from the Father and the Son. The Father and the Son is adored and glorified, was spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and look forward to the resurrection of the dead, the life of the world to come. Amen. My dear friends, we lift up our hearts to our dear Father, as we prepare ourselves for the coming of his Son into the world. May he help our heart and mind and will as we say, Father, through the coming of your Son, show us your love and salvation.
Father, through the coming of your Son, show us your love and salvation.
For the Church, may Pope Francis, bishops, priests, deacons, and the lay faithful, prepare wholeheartedly for the coming of your Son and our Savior, through and in our faithful love and service to each other. We pray.
Father, through the coming of your Son, show us your love and salvation.
For all public servants, make their hearts more open for the coming of the Savior, so that they may become instruments of your redemption. We pray.
Father, through the coming of your Son, show us your love and salvation.
For all of us gathered today, may our discernment and decisions make this week become a manifestation of the coming of your Son, the coming of love and life. We pray.
Father, through the coming of your Son, show us your love and salvation.
For those who are undergoing great suffering, be their sure consolation and healing, physical, emotional, and spiritual, O Father, that they may find rest amidst their desolation. We pray.
Father, through the coming of your Son, show us your love and salvation.
For our departed loved ones, welcome them back into your loving arms. We pray.
Father, through the coming of your Son, show us your love and salvation.
Let us pray for the urgent concerns of our community and our personal intentions. We pray.
Father, through the coming of your Son, show us your love and salvation. God, our Father, direct our hearts as we prepare for the coming of your communion and salvation through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
please all rise.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all this holy church.
Accept, we pray, O Lord, these offerings we make, gathered from among your gifts to us, and may what you grant us to celebrate devoutly here below gain for us the prize of eternal redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation, that when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Thank you.
ours to celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Patricio, our Bishop, Vicente, our Bishop Emeritus, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Our Lady of Mount Carmel, with Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, Saint Sebastian, Saint Lorenzo Ruiz, Saint Pedro Calungsod, Saint Teresa of Avila, Saint Teresa of the Child Jesus, Saint John of the Cross, all the saints who please you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we now dare to say. Lord, we pray from every evil and graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ has said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. Live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
As offered shall a sign of peace. Peace.
Of God, you take away.
Friends, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Body of Christ.
Amen. For those who are joining our live stream celebration, let us now pray the spiritual communion prayer. O my Jesus, I believe that you are truly present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you and I desire you to come into my heart. Since I cannot receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you. O never leave me. May the burning and most sweet power of your love consume me, that I may die for you, who died for love of me. Amen. Please all rise.
Let us pray. May these mysteries, O Lord, in which we have participated, profit us, we pray. For even now, as we walk with amid passing things, you teach us by them to love the things of heaven and hold fast to what endures, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Prayer of the Synod. We stand before you, Holy Spirit, as we gather together in your name, with you alone to guide us. Make yourself at home in our hearts. Teach us the way we must go and how we are to pursue it. We are weak and sinful. Do not let us promote disorder. Do not let ignorance lead us down the wrong path, nor partiality influence our actions. Let us find in you our unity, so that we may journey together to eternal life and not stray from the way of truth and what is right. All this we ask of you, who are at work in every place and time, in the communion of the Father and the Son, forever and ever. Amen.
I'd like to thank you for your prayers. The Diocese of Bacolod, the clergy, has just finished our financial and pastoral assessment last November 21 to 25 at Mambukal, and it was a grace-filled experience. Continue to pray that all the resolutions and the things that we have decided on be implemented, you know, for the transformation of the Diocese of Bacolod in terms of its pastoral and financial life. So we entrust all of our plans to the Lord. And likewise, as parents, please prepare your homes, your families in this kind of disposition, as the Church likewise reminds us of the disposition of Advent. I'll now give the solemn blessings. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads to receive God's blessings. May the Almighty and merciful God, by whose grace you have placed your faith in the first coming of his only begotten Son, and yearn for his coming again, sanctify you by the radiance of Christ's advent, and enrich you with his blessing.
Amen.
As you run the race of this present life, may he make you firm in faith, joyful in hope, and active in charity.
Amen.
So that rejoicing now with devotion at the Redeemer's coming in the flesh, you may be endowed with the rich reward of eternal life when he comes again in majesty.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Our Eucharist has been offered. Let us now go in peace.
Thanks be to God.